Hi guys, welcome back to JoJo Lab. It's only been several months since we posted the charging review of iQOO 10 Pro. You can click the upper right corner to check that. Now we got the latest iQOO 11 with Snapdragon 8 Gen 2. And we will test its charging performance. Let's start. The battery capacity of iQOO 11 is 5000 mAh. Two cells are connected in series, and it can support 120 watts fast charging. So it contains a 120 watts charging kit inside the box. The 120 watts charger is relatively small. The maximum output can be up to 20 volts, 6 amp. But the PD and PPS protocol will be limited to 65 watts. And the charging cable can support 6 amp current. The JoJo Lab Power ZKM-002C can only detect the built-in market chip of PD protocol. It supports 100 watts and USB 2.0. And our tester also shows it supports QC 2.0, PD 3.0, QC 5, and PPS protocol. It also has 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. The size of the charger is about 60x52x28mm, weight is about 121 grams. The power density is 1.3 watts cubic centimeter. Compared with iQOO 200 watts charger we took about before, the size is almost the same. Both can support up to 65 watts PD protocol, which means those two chargers have the same compatibility for third-party devices. Next, let's go ahead and test the charging performance of iQOO 11. First, the compatibility. For the original chargers from iQOO, there is no compatibility issue. We used iQOO 200 watts, original 120 watts and 120 watts USB-A chargers to charge the phone. The power can reach more than 100 watts, but it'll stabilize at around 70 watts in the end. As for smartphones from other brands, we made a chart for you to compare them intuitively. Since the Xiaomi 35 watts can support UFCS protocol, the power is slightly higher. Most of them, whether 20 watts or 100 watts chargers, can only reach about 9 volts, 18 watts. Then we'll use the original 120 watts charger and a cable to fully charge the iQOO 11. In the beginning, the voltage increased from 15 volts to 18 volts. The peak power is about 107 watts. At 1 minute and 42 seconds, the power suddenly dropped to 80 watts, and then dropped to 66 watts. From 9 minutes to 11 minutes 50 seconds, the power fluctuates between 50 to 66 watts with current and voltage. The voltage also dropped from 18 volts to 5 volts, and then back to 9 volts. After that, the power gradually decreased. It takes 25 minutes to be fully charged. We also draw it into another curve to see how fast it is. It can be charged to 50% in only 7 minutes, 80% in 15 minutes, and 100% in 25 minutes. Except for charging speed, the charging temperature is also what customers focus on. After 5 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 38.6 degrees Celsius and 42.1 degrees Celsius on the back. After 15 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 38.1 degrees Celsius and 39.2 degrees Celsius on the back. So the overall temperature is pretty stable at around 38 to 39 degrees Celsius, close to your body temperature. Well, that's all tests for the iQOO 11. With the 120 watts charger, it can be fully charged within 25 minutes, and the charging temperature is well controlled at around 38 to 39 degrees Celsius. So you just feel a little warm when you hold it. Like most Android phones, the compatibility of original charger is not very good, so it cannot reach the highest charging speed for third-party devices. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments down below, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!